What is up, folks? This is Ericast, and welcome back to Terraria. Alright, so, some things happened. Crap! I can't get away from the spoilers. Alright, some things happened, and, obviously this is, the beginning of a new episode, so I continued on the last episode because, well, I didn't really want to make a 15-minute video of Terraria. And yeah, so I continued on and did something else. But unfortunately, that one, that segment made the video last to the point where it was extremely long. So this episode is going to be a little bit shorter than usual as well, but it's not going to be as short as the last one. And it's going to include a certain event, which you will see in a few seconds. But I just wanted to make this intro real quick, explaining what happened, what's going on. So, I hope you guys enjoy. Alrighty, folks. So, I've gotten 4 of these made right now. It takes 5 each of the ectoplasm, and it takes some colored bars and some pumpkins. So, it's not that hard to make. Hey, you can actually see me at the moment. I had a just random... I was just sitting here minding my own business, waiting for nightfall. And just randomly, the King Slime just popped off my head. Just spawned there. I was like, okay. Not sure what you're doing here, but... Oh, crap. I actually need to go grab a few things from where I was just fighting bosses. Oh, that's not good. I've got a little bit until nightfall. Let's hurry, hurry. I am sorely tempted to make a set of magical items, accessories, and armor just to accommodate the fact that I got this thing, because it's amazing. It's a, yeah, it's absolutely incredible. But this thing is too, considering I just got the Unreal modifier for it, and holy cow, it does a lot of damage. Alright, so let's go ahead and hop back home. So, it shoots 5 shots at a time, right? Well, yeah. Still for a moment, well... When I'm on the move, it does 5 times 95 damage, so basically about 500 damage per shot. When I'm not... Actually, you know what? Let's put this up here on top of the roof. Actually, it makes a little bit more sense. When I'm standing still, it is 131 per shot. And where is the other? And you. And then I can do... Where is... Oh, there it is. Make sure I have 2 up, and we can probably something... Yep, there we go. Unfortunately, the candle doesn't actually affect spawn times, but I should be able to at least speed it up a little bit. Look at all the guys. Aren't they fun? This first wave isn't going to be a big deal. Let's go to the bomb as well. Oh, I'm out of mana. Holy cow, I'm getting some frame rate issues. I think it's mainly the fire that's the problem. Yeah, every time the fire shoots, it makes an issue. Okay, so we're already on wave 4. How nice. Alright, but now we start having fun, because the Morning Wood shows up. He is probably the biggest problem, even more so than the Pumpkin. Showing up though. Man, Morning Wood, where are you? Oh, that was what I wanted to use this one. You'll know by the fire that shoots through walls, and he moves through walls too. So. Hello. And apparently he can climb walls too. I didn't know that. So this arena, the problems that I was thinking about, are actually not going to be an issue if he just, like, climbs the walls. Oh, and that heart reach potion is amazing. Holy cow. Okay, yeah, see, look how quickly we're killing him. Not a problem. Now, he can kill us pretty quickly, too. Oh, our shots are not going after him. Alright, so we get our first pumpkin on this one. We also get the morning woods and everything else that shows up beforehand, so... what if we just throw some of these guys down there? Yeah, look how powerful these things are. This is ridiculous. Alright, not the weapons. There we go. Hello, pumpkin. Let's heal. And I think some of our buffs are wearing off. Okay, it looks like we're generally okay for the moment. Okay, pumpkin is just about dead. This seems easier. I mean, maybe it's just my imagination, but it seems easier. But hello, pumpkin. What are you doing? As I say, it seems easier. I realize my life is at like 300. So, there's that. Now, as you get further and further into waves, you have... Oh, the horseman's blade. Actually, it's probably not as good as my Xenopopper. I mean, not my Xenopopper, but the blade that I get from that. The same alien invasion. I think we definitely have lost some of our buffs now. Oh, we lost our food buff. Which is pretty important considering it gives us regen. But this is actually not turning out too badly. We're not even halfway through the night. Of course... Oh, we got a jack-o'-lantern launcher. Cool. And probably going to be wanting more bullets next time. I saw these guys. Oh, hello, pumpkin. But yeah, so this is mainly just going to be me flying around a lot. Because don't want to let pumpkin near you. But once we start getting several pumpkins, I imagine we're going to have issues. Oh, I was flying high enough I actually got a harpy after him. Oh, hello. But the advantage of the setup is while I'm killing this guy, all my traps down there are killing everything else. So, you know, it's actually not that bad of a setup. I'm glad. I haven't seen people add what we've got as far as the platforms up here on top, but I think that was actually a pretty good improvement over what I've mostly seen. Now, I actually can stand still for a little while and do some damage. Alright. Wave 11 is 94% complete. Oh, as long as I don't stand in the Greek fire. The Greek fire is probably, I would say, even more deadly than the pumpkin, honestly. I'm not going to worry about picking that up at the moment. Oh, hello. Yep, now we've got more than one pumpkin. Let's go ahead and buff again. Just see what we can get from it. And let's see. And, oh, horseman. Hello. You weren't really supposed to be up there. But as long as we can lead these guys in circles, I think we'll be generally okay. But our life-seeking bullets, I guess you could say, don't do as well when there's more than one target. Because it's, you know, depending on which is closer. Oh, hello, another pumpkin. Alright, so wave 12. I did put the nurse, and you may have noticed when I went back, wave 13. I put her in the room that I spawned in, so that should help. I might need to go down a little bit to... Oh, Greek fire. Okay. To make sure... Let's try buff again. Yeah, we got some more buffs. Let's see if I can get some parts. I don't think I got any. I think I took more damage than it was worth doing. Ooh, crap. I do have a heal coming up. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Wave 14. Now, there are 15 waves, just in case you don't know. And, gosh. I actually didn't think I'd make it this far on the first time, to be quite honest. This guy's almost dead. Alright, he's dead. And I'll get some buffs. Awesome. So, oh, lots of horsemen. Let's see if we can avoid the Greek fire for the most part. Oh, hello, pumpkin. I wasn't wanting you to show up just yet. But, well, I guess they don't really ask me. So we've got two of them. Oh, and they're throwing. I'm hoping I get some hearts from that. If we can kill one of them, we can get the hearts from him. Which would be a very, very good thing. The one on the left is almost dead. Oh, great. Now there's three of them. we can heal, though. Okay. And then we can get some hearts. Okay, so that heals us up back to full. Awesome! We killed him! Or we killed the... We finished the pumpkin moon. Well, I mean, we can keep going all night long, of course. It's 3 a.m. But at least we finished it, and that's what I was wanting. More than anything, was just to see that it finished. Yeah, these guys are not... Hey, go away! Oh, another one. That's all I needed. How many are there? Like six? Oh, I'm out of bullets. Nice. How about you guys? Have some of those. I'm about to die. I'm so about to die. Yep, and then there's another one showing up. I'm definitely... Yeah, I'm dead. Oh my gosh, look at them all. How in the heck am I supposed to do that? Okay, so there's a bat scepter. There's a jack-o'-lantern launcher. Who knows what else? I dropped 72 gold. Wow. And you're not going to allow me to get out of here, are you? Get me out! Go away! Really? Out heal and buff, and I guess I can use my sphere. Oh, I got some large knives. But I don't have my main weapon. I can use this. But it's not made for... Actually, it might do decently. Okay, did they all just leave? Okay, I've got to dodge those, but it's daytime now, so phew. Oh, and I got a candy corn rifle. Cool. Alright, so what else? Oh, I got 9 pumpkin trophies. Okay, that happened. I've got several spider eggs. I hate spiders so much that I don't even want the money from them. Gosh, I got a lot of stuff here. Feathers, I don't need. I don't need the gel. I've got so much gel. I've got several bat scepters, which is cool, I guess. Hello, goblin scout. Yeah. I just got invaded by goblins earlier, and it's annoying. That doesn't help, as far as FPS goes. Okay, lots of spooky wood. And I didn't get anywhere near the amount of gold back that I could have. There's also some stuff down here. Sticky twig is material. What else can I get rid of? I'm trying to save the lead ore. I'm sure you're screaming at me to sell it. I mean, to trash it. But, I'm trying to save it for iron skin potions because I don't really have any. Oh, we got a... whatchamacallit? Oh, we got a scarecrow banner. I'm hanging this up. I can't believe I killed that many scarecrows. Okay, there you go. And... there's just some pants here. And my lizard. I think I've got some... explosive jacket. That's kind of scary. Okay, and what was it that I picked up? I picked up these mummy leggings, didn't I? Okay, so let's just trash that. I could get rid of that too, but eh, whatever. Is that everything? There's scarecrow hat. Yeah, I'm not going to really worry about this stuff. Just random armor. Eugene the merchant has arrived. Apparently he died during the night. Oh, Raven staff. Okay, so I got Bat Scepter and Raven Staff. I think the Raven Staff is kind of like the thing. Bee thing? Oh, no. This one's the bee one. Yeah. Bats everywhere. I'll just carry it. Alright, so we'll check out everything in just a second. But I need to sell the extras just so I have room. Okay, so we can sell the bat scepter. And what else have we got? We've got jack-o'-lantern launcher, The weak one would definitely want to sell because it's terrible. I think we're fine on everything else. Alright, so... Oh, we have the Huntsman Blade. We've got two of these. Alright, so this one just by itself is 102 melee damage. And this one's 165. It is superior, but it's clearly just going to be better. The Influx Waver is. The Horseman's Blade is actually better, theoretically, than the Terra Blade. If you notice, there's something that's not happening here. Okay, so it's not shooting a projectile, and that's what makes the Terra Blade better in a lot of situations. Because of the projectile, you can stay away from mobs. So just like the Influx Waver here, it shoots projectile. Potentially, I was thinking about doing a melee build that is based around the fact that I can do this. So we've also got, what? I've already had those. We've got the Candy Corn Rifle, which is actually a really good weapon. So the bullets ricochet and it's candy corn, which is, oops, awesome. Accidentally hit my glass. 111 range damage, that's not bad. Not as good as the Xenopopper in any form or fashion. Well, it has a 33% chance not to shoot, consume its stuff, so I guess that's superior. Meh. Alright. I'll just put these in here so I can clear up some area. What else have we got? We've got the stake launcher. We've got a shoddy one, which is kind of crappy. So it has a lot of damage on it. It's a shoddy one, which is 11% in the negative of damage and knockback. But it still does 147 range damage. The reason is it's kind of slow as far as the fire rate of it goes. And the thing that this is really good against is vampires, which I think is awesome because it shows, like, I mean, what do with vampires? You stick them through the heart. But basically, it's an instant kill for vampires, which is pretty cool. And it has, again, its own ammo. We've got pumpkin trophy. I don't really have room in there. We'll stick you there just because it's a spot that's open. we've got the, showed you guys the Bat Scepter, and we've got our little Raven floating around. Unfortunately, the Raven is not as good as the Deadly Sphere, which makes me sad because I wanted to use the Raven. Spooky Twig is for, I can't remember what. Oh no, definitely not you. I'm trying to remember what that is. Is it for the wings? I think it's for the wings, the spooky wings, which I used for the longest time. I mean, they were what I used, but we've got the Fisheron rings now, which are better than the spooky ones, I'm pretty sure. I might switch over to the spooky wings if I find out that they're actually better. I like the way the spooky wings look, but these are just awesome. I mean, the acceleration on these things is amazing. But yeah, so I think that's it. Oh, I showed you guys the, man, that's a lot of damage. I still like this thing, but I mean, I guess we could replace our stinger with it, but that's funny. And it bounces around a long time before it explodes, just by itself. But yeah, I think that's it. We've got the spooky hook, which is also what I've used in the past. Oops. What am I using for my hook? We're using this. The Luminant Hook, which is the one that you get from the chest. The Mimic. I'm not sure which one's better, to be perfectly frank. I'm going to have to look it up. But... here's the spooky hook, and it's got the same as the aluminum hook. It's got three arms on it, so that's what that's like, and I'll have to look up to see which one's better. Pretty sure with the wings, it's exactly what I think is the case, but Yeah. So now we're going to have the end of the episode, and instead of being 15 minutes, I'm sure it's probably like 35 or 40 minutes. But, I don't know. I'm sure many of you will be very happy with that. But, yeah. So, that happened. We got a Morningwood trophy. Oh, cool. Because I didn't have one of those. I only had, like, 50 billion pumpkin trophies. So I'll just toss it up in here. I'm not really worried about building at the moment. I had some cool ideas, and I wanted to finish them, but I'm not a very good builder in Terraria. And so I kind of figured I'll just kind of face that fact and just deal with it. I'll do my building in Minecraft, and I actually made a pretty good building in Ragecraft 2. But unfortunately, now that I'm doing Ragecraft 3 instead, I can't transfer my building over. I mean, I could. I could build it in the area that we are currently in, but I don't know. It just doesn't fit quite as well, I don't think. But anyway, next time we'll probably take on the Frost Moon, and if all goes well, we might even take on something else. Something that was in the intro to the series. I actually kind of like that intro. It reminds me of some of the old... Actually, it kind of reminds me of Castlevania. The beginning of Castlevania Symphony of the Night. But yeah, anyway. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. And until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day.